the testimony of Hamashi Yakihara Shot.
That's us, man. So we know what to expect. But we know this also. Give me, I'm looking at, give me Job, the 5th chapter, the 19th verse. Job 5:19. That's why it's very important that we come back to the Most High. Power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So we know the devil have a plot to come down upon those that keep the commandments of the Most High and have a true testimony of Hamashiach that was shines we're bringing forth to you. That's the Hebrew Israelites, who you are. Read.
The book of Job, chapter 5, verse 19. He shall deliver thee in 6 troubles.
Yeah. This is what the Most High is going to do. He's going to deliver us in 6 troubles. Come on.
Yeah. In 7 there shall no evil touch thee.
Yeah. And 7 shall no evil touch the ones that's keeping the laws of the Most High. Having the faith of Hamashiach that was shy, right?
In famine he shall redeem thee from death.
That famine, it's gonna be food shortage. You ain't gonna be able to go to the store and get no food. Burger King ain't gonna be open. You ain't gonna be able to get McDonald's or none of these fast food places. In famine, when there's the food shortage, it's gonna be all because of the lack of food and great tribulation in this world. B.
And in war, from the power of the sword.
And in war, war is coming to every street in this, in America and all across the world. He said, in war, what?
In war, from the power of the sword.
In war, from the power of the sword. We better come back to the Most High. That's our only hope. Read.
Thou shalt be hid from the scourge of the tongue.
Yeah, you're going to be hid from the scourge of the tongue. All the things are going to be said. We're going to hear nothing. If you're in the spirit with the Most High. Me.
Neither shalt thou be afraid of destruction when it cometh.
Yeah, neither shall I be afraid when destruction cometh. Me.
At destruction and famine thou shalt laugh.
This is what we want to be at, people. But some of you ain't going to be laughing. You're going to be crying. It's going to be too late to cry. You're going to be, oh, Most High God, please, please save me. I'm hungry. I ain't got no food. It's all this hell around me. Because I tell you what, racial wars is coming to the streets of America. And that's every man hand against his neighbor for the lack of food and for great tribulation. It's coming, y'all. Read.
At destruction and famine thou shalt laugh.
At destruction and famine, it says, those that the Most High gonna cover them, so they're gonna be able to laugh. Read.
Neither shalt thou be afraid of the beast of the earth.
That you know the beasts of the earth, they're gonna be hungry too. They're going to be eating people up. Come on.
For thou shalt be in league with the stones of the field.
That we're going to be in league with the stones of the field, man.
And the beasts of the field shall be at peace with thee.
Yeah, that's what you want to be. That's what you want to be, people. So the beasts of the field going to be at peace with us. But doing what? Letting our bodies be a living sacrifice and come forth and bring the word of the Most High to our people to open you up to the truth, man. And come out of darkness into the light. This Psalms 91:1. It's time. It's time. It's getting closer and closer to that time where ain't gonna be no time for you to sit here and listen to this word. You better have it in your spirit. Read.
The book of Psalms chapter 91 verse 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
That's right. That's where we want to be at. And hopefully you want to be there. But you better be there before the destruction come. He said you're going to be abide in the shadow of the Most High. Come on.
I will say of the Most High, he is my refuge and my fortress.
That's our refuge and our fortress, our protection. Come on.
My power.
Come on.
In him will I trust.
I'm going to trust in the Most High, not in man. Right?
Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler.
He's going to deliver you from the snare, the trap. All these traps they got set up for us.
Really? And from the noisome pestilence, he shall cover thee with his feathers.
Hear that? The noisome pestilence. When they shoot their missiles to America to destroy this place, you better be safe. You better know where you're going to be at with the Most High. And don't wait till that time to call on him. It's going to be too late then, y'all. Read.
He shall cover thee with his feathers.
Most High say gonna cover his anointed, his chosen, his remnant, the one-third of the 12 tribes of Israel with his feathers. Come on. And under his wings shalt thou trust. Yeah. Under his wings shall we trust. Come on. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. His truth. Which is what? What's the truth? Hold that. What's his truth? That's going to be our shield and buckler. What's his truth? That's going to be our protection. Let's find out what the truth is. The book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth. So the law of the Most High that we're supposed to be following and following, you got to learn it, live it, and apply it in your life, y'all. That's going to be our protection. So how are you going to think he's going to protect you and you ain't even got to follow him? You ain't got to do what he say do. Just do whatever you want to do. Follow your own heart. And you think he's going to protect you? I don't think so, y'all. Y'all better understand and overstand. Read. The book of Psalms chapter 91 verse 5. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night. Let you give you a clue that terror's coming at night. But those that are the elect of the Most High will not be afraid when these missiles be shot into the ends of the world. Read. Nor for the arrow that flies by day. What did it say? Nor for the arrow that flies by day. Giving you clues, the missile gonna come in the daytime. Read. Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness.
Yeah, the pestilence that walketh in darkness, man. Come on.
Nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday.
And you know, in the day, at noonday,
destruction coming to this earth, y'all. Where you gonna be at then? It's gonna be too late to call on him. But he got something for you, man. That's why, get Ephesians 6 and 9 and 10 down. Gotta understand, man, that's why we gotta have the protection of the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In the name of the anointed Savior. Read that.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 9. And ye, masters, do the same things unto them, forbearing, threatening, knowing that your master also is in heaven. Neither is there respect of persons with him.
That's right, man. Everybody that's a leader better hear what he's saying, because you're going to have to pay for how you treat the Most High's people. And the Most High have no respect of persons. Read.
Finally, my brethren,
who are the Israelites, read.
Be strong by Shalom, you have a shot. And in the power of his might, put on the whole armor of the Most High.
That's right.
Put on the whole protection of our Heavenly Father, the power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Put on the whole armor, because the armor is put on for protection, to protect your body. Put on the whole armor of the Most High, read. That ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Hey, you got to stand against who?
The wiles of the devil.
The wiles of the devil. Come on. Give me a, hold that. Give me a Revelation 2 and 10. You got to be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Who the devil? Right here. Read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 10.
How you doing, sir?
Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer.
They don't fear none of the things you're going to suffer. Read.
Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison.
You hear what he said? The devil going to cast some of you Israelites into what?
Into prison.
That's the devil. The devil going to cast you into prison, man. Go back to where you was at. Read that again. Concerning the devil. The devil means deceitful and evil person, man. Devils are deceitful and evil people. Read, that's operating under the power of Satan. Read.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 11. Put on the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
We got
to
stand against the wiles of the devil. Give me first, hold that, get 1 Peter 5 and 8. We got to stand against the wiles of the devil. Because he's doing this, y'all. Read.
The book of 1 Peter, chapter 5, verse 8. Be sober.
You got to be sober, man. Be focused. Don't be walking out here drunk, man. You got to be focused at all times, man. Be focused. Be sober. Read.
Be vigilant.
You got to be vigilant. Read.
Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
The devil. walking about where? Up and down and to and fro in the earth, seeking who he could kill, man, who could devour. Yes. Hmm? What kind of candy? Huh? How much are they? One for a dollar?
Yeah. I'll help you out. I gotta support my boy because he's doing something. You know, he waited patiently and
of the Most High, man. My Shekinah told us this in Mark, the 11th chapter and the 22nd verse, man. Read that. He told us this, man. This is our only hope. Man, ain't that much time that you're going to hear this. Read. The book of St. Mark, chapter 11, verse 22. And Hamashiach Yahushua answering, saith unto them, have faith in the Most High power. Read that again. The book of St. Mark, chapter 11, verse 22. And Hamashiach Yahushua answering, saith unto them, have faith in the Most High power. We got to have faith in the Most High, man. That's our only hope, to believe in him. He's the only, that's why I say you got to put on the whole armor of the Most High. So you got armor of yourself, man. You think you're going to be able to protect yourself? Now, man. This ain't no physical battle that you're going to win initially. It's spiritual. That's why I go back to Ephesians 6 and 11. Let's read it. The book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 11. Put on the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Yeah.
Put on the whole protection of the Most High, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Come on. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. We ain't wrestling with flesh and blood. Read. But against principalities.
Against principalities.
Read? Against powers.
Against powers, man.
That's against us. Read? Against the rulers of the darkness of this world.
Against the rulers of the darkness of this world.
Come on. Against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yeah.
Spiritual demons, man, in high places. That's what you're wrestling against. And the spiritual demons in high places come down here and get in the minds of people to have them do the wickedness of darkness that they would have them to do, and they're going to do it to you if you don't have the protection of the Most High. Power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob forever and ever and ever. This is what we're trying to tell you, man. Me. Verse 13. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of the Most High.
You got to take the whole armor of the Most High, man. You can't trust in man.
Man done let us down every single time, man. Every single man. Come on, gonna try and save us. We ain't gonna be saved by no man. We got a big power that ain't coming back as a man to redeem us and save us from the condition that we in right now. And his name is Hamashiach Yahweh Shai, that's coming back to set righteousness up on this earth and beat down and kill all his enemies so that we can have a righteous world, man. Other than that, man, you're gonna be walking around here like this. You're gonna be able to walk around and watch. When this white man come down with the wrath that he says the devil know he got a short time, gonna come down with much wrath, man. Because he know we got next. You might not know it, but he know it. Better believe that, Reed. That he may be able to withstand in the evil day. We're in the evil day, man. Get Proverbs 16:4. We're in the evil day, no matter how you look at it. It might not be amongst your realm right now, but it's coming. Listen, read. The book of Proverbs chapter 16, verse 4. The Most High Power have made all things for himself. Yeah, even the wicked for the day of evil. He Most High made everything for himself. Even the wicked for the day of evil. Who the wicked? Job 9:24. He made the evil, wicked man for the day of evil. Who the wicked? Let's read it. The book of Job chapter 9 verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. The earth been given to the hand of the wicked. Read. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. First and foremost, you open up your Bible, you see the so-called white man represent who? The Most High, who you call God. You see all the prophets. Oh, we got pictures right here. If you don't believe it, they're right here on this ground. Of all the prophets and the apostles, and of Hamashiach Yahweh Shai as himself. He covered the faces of the judges thereof, and Hamashiach Yahweh Shai coming to judge and make war. And he told the 12 apostles they're going to sit on 12 thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Now you going to tell me that last supper picture he ain't do this? Read it from the top. The book of Job chapter 9 verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. The earth been given to the hand of the wicked. Read. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. So he covered the faces of the judges thereof with his own face. Read. If not, if it ain't the so-called white man, read. Where and who is he? Because I ain't seen no Arabs do it. I ain't seen no Africans do it. I ain't seen no Chinese or Japanese do it. So who did it? The so-called white man. Simple as that. The so-called white man. You know. Come on, how y'all gonna not believe this? You know, come on, y'all gonna look at who the superpower of Earth at this time as the Arabs? Come on now. Think. That doesn't make no sense, man. Trump said, I'm gonna build a wall. And I'm gonna make the Mexicans pay for it. But he said, we gonna build a wall. So the people of America are gonna build that wall. You understand? What the Arabs just demanding somebody telling somebody what they gonna do? Where they at? Come on, man. This don't take a rocket science to figure out. That's why you got all these new age Israelites coming into power, man. They own power and bring forth these doctrines, man, that's crazy. Come on, you think the white man gonna give up his throne or power with authority? No, man. And what do they have to fight him? To think that he's the end of the world. Esau's the end of the world, like they the end of the world. Nah, man. Get out of here. Trump said in his when he was running for president, nuke them all! Nuke them! This cat said nuke them! And he said, go over there and make sure you get the oil. See, they went over there and did what they did. He said, hey, man, when you go over there, make sure you get the natural resources. Ain't that what they did to America? Raped this bad boy till ain't nothing here, hardly. Nothing here. Worth nothing. That's what I said. We done did all we can do in America. Now we're going to go outside America and start getting all the natural resources out the ground that we can from these other countries. Yeah, man. Who doing it? Y'all gotta be out of y'all mind. Y'all better understand this. The earth been given to the hand of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? Too many scriptures that back up the fact who the devil is. Deceitful and evil people. Y'all better wake up. Gonna be sitting around looking for something that's not gonna come. They're gonna catch you all off guard. Yep, looking for love in all the wrong places, right? That's right. Look, go back to Ephesians. The book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11. Put on the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Yeah, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, man, who's going up and down, to and fro the earth, seeing who he can devour. Read. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. We ain't wrestling with against flesh and blood. That's your flesh, y'all. Read. But against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yeah.
Spiritual demons, man, in high places. That's what we wrestling with. Read. On the left-hand side. Come on. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. Here we are. We're in the evil day. So I'm here to warn you through the Spirit of the Most High. You got to take on the whole armor, the protection of the Most High. He's our only protection. But see, a lot of you don't fear him, man. Give me that Luke 12 and 4. Y'all don't fear the Most High. Now you don't really know him. You think you the Most High. You your own power. And it's sad because you've been programmed to feel this way. When the Messiah come shy said this, right?
The book of St. Luke chapter 12 verse 4. And I say unto you, my friends, be not afraid of them that kill the body.
Tell us, don't be afraid of them that kill the body. There'll be a whole lot of death coming, man, right?
And after that, have no more that they can do.
After they kill a body, ain't nothing else they can do, right?
But I will forewarn you whom ye shall fear.
So I'm going to forewarn you who you be afraid of, who you should fear, right?
Fear him, which after he have killed, have power to cast into hell.
Said, fear him, that after he have killed, have power to cast your butt into hell, man. Read.
Yeah, I say unto you, fear him.
Say, yeah, I say unto you, fear him. But all some of y'all don't want to listen. Proverbs 1 and 7. See, y'all want to listen, but the Most High already told you that my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Proverbs 1 and 7.
The book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7. The fear of the Most High is the beginning of knowledge.
Yeah. The fear of the Most High is the beginning of knowledge. To be afraid of the Most High, you don't do what he said do. Just like whenever you hear woo-woo-woo behind you in the car. Oh, shoot all ya. Here they come, they get you. Especially if you ain't right. You know that feeling you get? Well, you know you're wrong. Oh, yeah. The fear of Most High, the beginning of knowledge. To be afraid of Most High, that's the beginning of knowledge. Read.
But fools despise wisdom and instruction.
See, fools despise wisdom and instruction. You see? Read.
My son.
Now give me a, hold that, give me a 1 Timothy 3:16. See, fools despise wisdom and instruction. But see, I don't want you to be that way, and I hope you're not that way, where you'll start to pay attention, more concerned with your life, because it's gonna come a time, man, when you got to apply this in your life. And if you're not applying this in your life, the Most I got something for you, man. I'm trying to warn you. Read.
3:16. The book of 1 Timothy, chapter 3, verse 16. And without controversy, great is the mystery of righteousness.
Hear that? Great is the mystery. If it's a mystery, what does that mean? You don't know what's going on. It's a secret. Righteousness is a secret. That's why we're here to reveal the secret to you. Come on.
The Most High power was manifest sluggard. Hamashiach Yahushai was manifest in the flesh.
Hamashiach Yahushai was manifest in the flesh, y'all. Right?
Justified in the spirit.
Justified in the spirit.
Seen of angels.
Seen of angels. Come on.
Preached unto the Gentiles.
Preached unto the Gentiles. Come on.
Believed on in the world.
Believed on in the world. Come on.
Received up into glory.
He was received up into the right hand side of the Most High.
Really? Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter time,
in the last days, and here we are, we're in the last days. In the last days, come on.
Some shall depart from the faith.
Some gonna depart from the faith in the Most High. That's why we went to Mark 11:22. You gotta have faith in the Most High. You gotta believe in Him. He's our only hope. Everything else matters null and void. You gonna depend on yourself? You don't have the means to be able to deal with what's getting ready to go down on this earth. You don't have the means to deal with that. Read that again in the last day.
That in the latter times, some shall depart from the faith.
In the last days, man, some gonna depart from believing in the Most High. Thinking it's a joke until the Most High deal with what He's gonna deal with you on. Read.
Giving heed to seducing spirits.
Yeah, giving heed to seducing spirits. Spirits that seduce you.
Read. And doctrines of devils.
And what?
And doctrines of devils.
And doctrines of devils. So that let you know that the devil have what?
Doctrines.
Doctrines. You see? And that's where a lot of y'all coming up new in this truth, and y'all, some of y'all done learned a little bit, y'all think y'all on point, but you dealing with what?
Doctrines of devils.
Doctrines of devils.
Come on.
Speaking lies and hypocrisy.
Speaking lies and hypocrisy.
Come on.
Having their conscience seared with a hot iron.
And you can't tell them nothing. Because their conscience, their minds are seared like a hot iron. You know how a hot iron, you burn something, that mark that iron gonna leave gonna be there forever. You can't get rid of that. And that's how their minds are seared like a hot iron.
Come on. Forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats, which the Most High Power have created to be received with thanksgiving.
Oh yeah, all you gotta do is pray over it. And it's good to eat.
Nah, man. That's what the churches use for that saying that you can eat whatever you wanna eat.
Nah.
The Most High gave us dietary laws in Leviticus 11 chapter. Clean meats and unclean meats. You ain't supposed to eat no pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, catfish, oysters. Shrimp? What?
Crawfish.
Yep. Oysters, lobsters, crabs, crawfish, crawdads. Y'all ain't supposed to eat all that. That's why we got all these problems, diseases and so forth. And you gotta read the labels of things. They got these names all camouflaged. Shellfish and all that stuff. In your noodles. In the mixture that you put in your noodles. Got abomination in it. You better start reading. That's why I say, you gonna keep several months, what they say, put it in a book. So you better start reading. You care about your health. Cause them doctors gonna make a whole lot of money out of us. Let's read.
With thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth.
With them that believe and know the laws, statutes, commandments of the Most High. Because you know the laws, statutes, commandments of the Most High, you ain't going to be eating abomination. You ain't going to let them take you there and say you can eat whatever you want to eat. All you got to do is pray over it. That's foolishness. See? That's why we got to come out of this. Give me a second. Timothy 3:16. See, we got to come out of this. It's very important. Don't let them just tell you anything. That's the devil. Doctrines of devils. Read.
The book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16. All scripture is given by inspiration of the Most High.
That all scripture is given by the inspiration of the Most High. The Spirit of the Most High.
Come on.
And it's profitable for doctrine.
It's profitable for doctrine.
The right doctrine, though, not the doctrine of devils.
Come on.
For reproof.
For reproof.
To reproof you.
Read.
For correction.
To correct you.
Come on.
For instruction in righteousness.
For instruction in righteousness. How to follow the laws, statutes, commandments of the Most High Power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Come on.
That the man of the Most High may be perfect.
The man of the Most High may be perfect. The only way you're going to be perfect is to follow the law, statute, commandments of the Most High. Come on.
That the man of the Most High may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works.
That's right, man.
Thoroughly furnished. And to hollow follow the Most High's law, statute, commandments.
Give me Psalm 19, 7. That's right.
So we are people, man, that's been destroyed for lack of knowledge. We don't know who we are. We the children of Israel. We gonna be priests and kings, man. That's right, brother. That's right. We got it. That's right, man. Read. The book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 7. The law of the Most High is perfect. The law of the Most High. You wanna be perfect, you gotta follow the law of the Most High. Cause what he say? The law of the Most High is perfect.
The law of the Most High is perfect, Greg.
Converting the soul.
Converting the soul, man. Converting you
to righteousness. Come on. The testimony of the Most High is sure.
Testimony of the Most High in this Bible is sure.
Come on. Making wise the simple.
Making wise the simple. That's why I said, hey, give me Proverbs 1:22. See? Proverbs 1:22. Right. All right, have a blessed one, brother. Psalms, Proverbs 1:22.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 22.
It says, the laws of the Most High will make wise the simple-minded. That's why he's saying this to you.
How long, ye simple ones?
How long, ye simple ones, Rick?
Will ye love simplicity?
So not to follow the laws, statutes, commandments of the Most High, you love what?
Simplicity.
You love simplicity. Come on. Don't you want to be wise? Come on, I'll tell you, man, how the lies, the earth didn't help us through the archaeology, anthropology, geography, and the history, the true our story of this Bible, to bring us out of this darkness, man, out of the ignorance, to bring us to the marvelous light of the Most High, to shine bright and illuminate, be illuminated in this wicked world, man, and not be at war with the Most High, and be the friend of the Most High, be the friend of Mashiach Yahushua. They're not the enemy of the Most High, the enemy of Mashiach Yahushua, because he going to get you. He ain't playing. He going to start with us. He going to start with us. That's why you see the things happening in this world right now. Oh, y'all think, oh, the Most High ain't got his hand on it. The Most High got his hand on everything. That's why you better come back to him. Read.
How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity?
Will you love simplicity, you simple ones, he's saying.
But the law of the Most High can make the simple be wise. It's all a formula here. What you here for bear? Just what works.
Me.
And the scorners delight in their scorning.
The scorners delight in their scornings, man. Going back and forth against us. We bring forth the unadulterated truth to our people, man, to bring them out of darkness into the light. Come on.
And fools hate knowledge.
So, when you don't want this knowledge, you're a fool, he's saying. Jump to verse 24.
Because I have called, and ye refuse.
They ain't calling you. When we come out on these streets and call our people back to the sheepfold of knowing who you are as an Israelite, he said, he called, and you refused.
Read. I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded.
He said, he stretched off his hand. His hand. And no man regarded. He's trying to get your attention. Who's his hand? Hey, man, give me one of them. Give me one of them, man. Give me a black one. Okay, Tawada, man. Tawada, thank you. I want a handpiece. I want an implant. Yeah. Yeah. I know. Huh?
Hey,
hold
this
out.
I'm right here, man. Get a black. Let me shout
right now, y'all right here.
Yeah, man.
I ain't
know y'all. I'm dying.
Get your boy, man.
He lasts
longer than welcome was
out
here. Yeah.
All right.
All right,
man.
What's up,
man? The water.
Hands with that.
So read that again in Proverbs 1:24. The book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 24. Because I have called And ye refuse.
They called and we refuse, man. He calling you to come back to the sheepfold. You are the children of Israel. The Most High love you.
Read.
I have stretched out my hand.
Say, stretch out his hand.
Read.
And no man regarded.
Yeah, no man regarded. Psalms 17 and 14. He said he stretched forth his hand. So what is he doing? What is he talking about? Because it's hip talk. Let's find out what he's saying, right?
The book of Psalms, chapter 17, verse 14. Uh-huh. From men which are thy hand.
What? From men which are the Most High's hand.
Come on.
Oh, Yahweh. From men of the world which have their portion in this life. From men of the world. Here we are right now. Which had a portion of his life, man. Men are the hand of the Most High. Get Proverbs 8 and 4. See, he called men to bring forth his word, which is the hand of the Most High, man. Read that.
The book of Proverbs chapter 8 verse 4. Unto you, O men, I call.
Yeah. Unto you, O men, I call.
Read. And my voice is to the sons of man.
His voice is to the sons of man. So go back to Proverbs 1 and 24. Y'all know y'all Israelites? That's who you are, man.
The book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 24. Because I have called and ye refuse.
Say, he called and you refuse, man.
I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded.
He kept men going on the streets, man, bringing forth this truth. Stretch of his hand, the men that's coming out to bring this truth out. And no man regarded. Give me Hosea 1 and 10. See? This ain't something that just started. It's been that way. He stretched out his hand. He had men that he called to bring forth this truth to our people, the children of Israel. Read that.
The book of Hosea, chapter 1, verse 10. Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea.
See that? The number of us gonna be as the sand of the sea. Numerous, man. You can't measure no sand of the sea. That's how numerous we gonna be, right?
Which cannot be measured.
Cannot be measured.
Nor numbered.
Nor numbered.
Right? And it shall come to pass. It's
gonna come to pass
that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people.
Yeah, what we taught here in America, we Gentiles. Did we not taught that we the true Israelites, the 12 tribes of Israel? Judah all the way down to Israel. You ain't taught that in no churches. In the place where we were taught that we not the sons of the Most High.
Read. There it shall be said.
There shall be said
unto them.
Unto you as an Israelite.
What? Ye are the sons of the living power.
You are the sons of the living power. The Most High love you, Jacob, Israel.
Read. Then shall the children of Judah and the children of Israel be gathered together.
That's what we're doing right now, man. As you're being taught, man, you're hearing the voice of the Most High through His Word. Then we coming together, man, back into the sheepfold. As one nation, 12 nations that make up one nation, the 12 tribes of Israel. Go back to where you was at.
The book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 24. Because I have called and ye refused. I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded.
Yeah. He stretched out his hand and no man regarded. Romans 9:27. He stretched out his hand and no man regarded. Just like we heard in Hosea 1 and 10, man. We as the sand of the sea, man, that cannot be numbered. And the place where it was said that we not the Most High's holy people, there it should be told unto you that you are the holy people of the Most High. The chosen people of the Most High. Read this.
Let's see this. The book of Romans chapter 9 verse 27. Esaias also cried concerning.
That's Hosea. Read.
Though the number of the children of Israel be as the sand of the sea, a remnant shall be saved.
Now he's giving you more clarity. He said, though we be like the sand of the sea, a remnant, one third, gonna be saved.
Come on. For he will finish the work and cut it short in righteousness.
Yeah, he gonna finish the work and cut it short, man, in righteousness. Or else won't be no flesh left.
Come on. Because a short work with the Most High, why Hamashiach can have a shot, make up all of the earth.
That's right, man.
He gonna cut the time short, man, for the elect's sake. 1/3 of the 12 tribes of Israel, man. Y'all gotta understand this and overstand this point. That's why we're here to warn you before it's too late. Proverbs 1:24. The book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 24. Because I have called and ye refused. I have stretched out my hand and no man regard it. But ye have said at naught all my counsel. Think of that as nothing. You better understand it is the most something. This word of the Most High. Ain't nothing more important than the Most High. Ain't nothing more powerful than this truth. Read. And would none of my reproof. None of his reproof. A lot of you being reproof, you don't even recognize the Most High until it happened to you. Then you go back to doing the wicked stuff you was doing before. You gotta come out of that. You gotta change, man. You gotta become a new creature. You gotta be born again. That means in your mind and spirit and soul. That'll be righteous in the eyes of the Most High. And follow his laws that's come out, being obedient to him. Follow his rules and regulations. Y'all know about rules and regulations. Oh yeah, everybody respond to that. Read. Verse 26. I also will laugh at your calamity. He said he's gonna laugh. When your calamity come, calamity is coming, brothers and sisters. Hopefully this ain't you. He said he's gonna do what? I also will laugh at your calamity. He said gonna laugh at your calamity. Read. I will mock when your fear come. When your fear come, he said he's gonna mock you. Make fun of you. You mock somebody, you make fun of you. You make fun of them. He said, you're gonna mock when your fear come. Really? When your fear comes as desolation, when your fear come as desolation, you start losing everything, really? And your destruction cometh as a whirlwind. And your destruction come as what? As a whirlwind. As a whirlwind. Like a tornado, your destruction come like a tornado, like a hurricane, like a mad storm. When all this come upon you, read. When distress and anguish cometh upon you. Then shall they call upon me. When distress and anguish come upon you. He said, then you're going to call on him. Don't wait till this time, y'all. Because it's going to be too late. He said, when all this havoc, all this hell start come upon you, say, then you're going to call upon him. Who you call God, read. But I will not answer. You hear what he said? I will not answer. You want to make sure, hold that, whenever you need him, he's there to answer you at your beckoning call. But you better have a relationship with him before this happened. Read. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. I'm telling you, you're going to seek him early, but shall not find him. Read. For that they hated knowledge, and did not choose the fear of the Most High.
Hear that?
They hated knowledge. And you tell you, our people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because they have forgotten the law of the Most High. And the fear of the Most High, to be afraid of him, is the beginning of knowledge. So if you're afraid of him, you're going to do wicked things. You want to know what pleases him, what's right from wrong. So we all been born into a world of good and evil, man. Because we ate of that tree of good and evil from the beginning. So here we are now in the condition that we're in, thinking you're going to come out of it on your own. You only got one way, man. And that's through the Most High's law, statutes, commandments, and faith in the Mashiach Yahushua. Ain't no other way. You're going to find out. That's why he's telling you. When he brings destruction upon you, then he's going to use his sword, who is a so-called white man, to bring it on you. Y'all better understand this. Y'all ain't hearing me though. But you gon' hear. You gon' remember these words. Because the Most High word don't go out void. Y'all better hear the word of the Most High. Here to warn you. Come on. Verse 29. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Most High, they would none of my counsel. They despised all my reproof. Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way.
Yeah.
You're going to eat of the fruit of your own way. The way you think. You're going to be on your own. Read. And be filled with their own devices.
Or be filled with your own devices.
Whatever you can come up with. To help yourself. Read. For the turning away of the simple strong shall slay them.
The turning away of the simple shall slay you.
I'm telling you, man, I'm going to kill you.
Right?
And the prosperity of fools shall destroy them.
The prosperity of fools shall destroy them.
You say fools hate what?
Knowledge.
The prosperity of fools that hate the knowledge of the Most High gonna destroy you.
But y'all understand. Y'all think our enemy know